तृष्ण कांक्षित आणि पदार्थ नाश पदार्थ प्राप्ती पदार्थ विकार पदार्थ संस्कार रूपाणी फलान्यपि न सन्ति। निलास पाठ विश्व उत्पत्ति सॉरी उत्पत्ति वॉज डिनाइड फॉर दी फल दी फल मोक्ष इज नॉट अ फल ऑफ एनी कर्म और उपासना बिकॉज कर्म और उपासना कैन ब्रिंग अबाउट ओनली उत्पत्ति इत्यादि विकारास विच हैव बीन सीन नॉट विकारास रियली उत्पत्ति इज काइंड ऑफ फलास सो व्हाट वाज मेंशनड अर्लियर अमंग देम द फर्स्ट हैज बीन डिनाइड उत्पत्ति आप्ति विकार संस्कार एंड नाश इन दैट उत्पत्ति हैज बीन एलोबरेटली एनालाइज एंड डिनाइड नाउ द अदर्स आल्सो निगेटेड इन दिस आवर्त 392nd आवर्त यथा दंड प्रहार रूप कर्मणा घटनाश रूपं फलं भवति तथा मुमुक्षो कर्मणा कस्यचिदपि पदार्थस्य नाश रूपं फलं युज्यते। सो दी पदार्थ कैन अंडरगो नाश विच हैज उत्पत्ति एग्जाम्पल गिवन इज घटनाश इज पॉसिबल बाय दंड प्रहार बाय कर्म विच इज हिटिंग बाय स्टिक हिटिंग दी घटा बाय स्टिक अन्य पदार्थानां नाशो न मुमुक्षो कांक्षितः हाउएवर दी अन्य पदार्थ घटादि पदार्थ नाश इज नॉट व्हाट मुमुक्षु इज लुकिंग फॉर ही इज नॉट लुकिंग फॉर जगन्नाश ही इज लुकिंग फॉर बंधनाश बंध इज नॉट रियली एन एग्जिस्टिंग पदार्थ सो अन्य पदार्थान नाशः न मुमुक्षो कांक्षितः किंतु बंधनाश एव कांक्षितः सच बंध आत्मनि नास्ति एंड इट इज नॉट देयर इन आत्मा एट ऑल दिस बंध so bandhanasha is not going to take place the way there is ghatanasha by a karma or an upasana similarly there is no possibility of bandhanasha because bandha is not there in atma kintu mithya bandha atmani pratiyate the bandha is mithya in atma there is a pratiti but pratiti does not make it real sacha mithya pratiti karmana nanashyet just like rajju sarpa Nasha will not take place with danda ityadi. Similarly, bandhanasha won't take place. Atma yatharthya jnane naiva mithya pratitir nashyet. The mithya pratiti will go only by atma jnana adhishthana jnana. Tasman mukshu padartha nasha rupam karma sadhyam phalam nasti. There is no possibility of having moksha as a phala for a mumukshu. This is not a nash rupa phala also. We have seen the tippana. Then prapti apti or prapti as a phala is denied for a mumukshu. Yatha gamana rupa karmana grama prapti phalam bhavati tatha mumukshu karmana moksha prapti rupam phalam na bhavati. It is not something which is attainable. It is not a destination to be reached. Moksha is not a destination to be reached. Nitya muktasya atmanaha moksha prapti rupa phalavarnan na yuktam. You cannot talk about attainment of moksha or a destination to be reached because atma is ever mukta. Mukti is not a destination to be reached or not to be attained literally. Yasya bandha asti tasya moksha praptir varnayetum shakyate. If there is bandha, then you can talk about moksha as a prapti. But it is praptasya prapti atmani. बंधा भावात मोक्ष प्राप्ति रूपम फलमपि मुमुक्षो कर्मणा न सिद्ध्यति कर्म कैन नॉट ब्रिंग अबाउट दिस अटेनमेंट ऑफ मोक्ष यथा पाक रूप कर्मणा तंडुलस्य ओदनात्मक रूप रूपांतर प्राप्ति रूप विकारः पाचकस्य फलम सिद्ध्यति तथा मुमुक्षो कर्मणा विकार रूप फलमपि न युज्यते निर्विकारत्वाद आत्मनः जस्ट लाइक रॉ राइस इज कुक्ड and thereby it undergoes vikara so karma is cooking with the pachana kriya the raw rice becomes cooked rice it transforms similarly can mumukshu do some karma and attain moksha as a vikara of something that is also not possible why because atma is nirvikara atma cannot go from bandha rupa to moksha rupa there cannot be vikara possible atma is nirvikara यह आत्मनि प्रथमं बंधम अंगीकृत्य पश्चान मोक्ष दशायां चतुर्भुजत्वादि विलक्षण रूप प्राप्ति अंगीकरोति तस्य मते अन्य रूप प्राप्ति रूप विकारः मुमुक्षो कर्मणं कर्मण फलं भवेत्। देर आर अदर्स हू से चतुर्भुज विष्णु नारायण दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ फॉर्म आई वांट टू अटेन। सो सारूप्य मुक्ति वेयर दे टॉक अबाउट सारूप्य मुक्ति देयर दिस रूप परिणाम इज पॉसिबल बट इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन नित्य मुक्त नित्य मुक्ति इन दैट काइंड ऑफ नित्य मोक्ष इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल। तादृश अन्य रूप प्राप्ति आत्मना न अंगीक्रियते इवन देयर इट इज नॉट द चेंज इन आत्मा in the case of sarupya mukti also atma is not undergoing any change it is only anya sharira so anya shariram so it is anya sharira where mumukshu had a desire for sarupya mukti that kind of a mumukshu not a nitya moksha ichchu tasmat karmana vikara rupa phala siddhirapi mumukshur nasti so this vikara विकार रूप फल इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल इन द केस ऑफ आत्मा यथा वस्त्र से क्षालन रूप कर्मण मल निवृत्ति रूप संस्कार होती तथा मल निवृत्ति रूप संस्कार मोक्षो कर्मण न फलम। सो कर्म फल अनदर कर्म फल इज संस्कार प्यूरिफिकेशन कैन यू ब्रिंग अबाउट प्यूरिफिकेशन इन आत्मा एंड गेट मोक्ष दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल अनलाइक vastra can be washed and with kshalana with kshalan rupa karma by washing karma you can clean mala nivrutti such kind of sanskara is not possible in atma anyasya mala nivrutti moksho karmana na vanchita sharira chitta all these can undergo kshalana and thereby sanskara but mokshu is not looking for that mokshu is looking for moksha किंतु आत्मनः मलनिवृत्तिरेव वांछिता इति वक्तव्यम्। सो मलनिवृत्ति इज पॉसिबल थ्रू क्षालन कर्म इफ मोक्ष इज अटेनेबल थ्रू संस्कार बाय वॉशिंग और बाय प्यूरिफिकेशन सम काइंड ऑफ कर्म लाइक वॉशिंग देन अन्य पदार्थ अनदर पदार्थ कैन बी वॉश्ड बाय द मुमुक्षु दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव टू से If purification is going to bring about moksha, then what is it that mumukshu is going to wash? It cannot be atma because atma is not anya padartha. Nitya shuddhi atmani cha malan nasti. And if you talk about atma itself being purified, the subject purifies himself, that is also not possible because not only kartru karmano virodha, but also there has to be mala in atma to be purified. Atma is mala rahita nitya shuddha. Therefore, also this sanskara rupa phala fructifying into moksha is not possible. Tasmat mala nivritti rupa sanskaro na ghatate. That kind of sanskara as a phala is not possible for a mumukshu. Antakkaranagata papa rupa malasya nivritti karma phalam iti uktira yadyapi satyayeva tathapi विचार्यमाणे शुद्धांतकरणः यः मुमुक्षु तस्य अंतकरणे न पापमस्ति। एंड इफ यू से देयर इज पापा एंड रिमूवल ऑफ पापा इज संस्कार ऑल्दो दैट इज राइट बट दिस मुमुक्षु इज मोक्ष इच्छु व्हेन विल ही बिकम अ मुमुक्षु इन द साधन चतुष्टय संपत्ति मुमुक्षुत्वम इज द लास्ट वन टू बी अटेन्ड। So the person should have chitta shuddhi before he can really be called as a mumukshu. Mumukshu is not one who desires moksha also. Mumukshu is one who desires moksha only. Considering that viveka vairagya sampanna, shamadabadi sampanna sadhaka is going to try for mumukshutvam and then he will become a mumukshu. Try to gain mumukshutvam. So he is already shuddha antakkarana. Then what papa is there to remove from the antakkarana for moksha? So if you inquire into it, vicharyamane sati shuddha antakkarana ya shuddha antakkaranam yasya mumukshoho sa mumukshuhu tasya mumukshoho अंतकरणे पापम नास्ति, देयर इज नो पाप इन अंतकरण, वी कैन नॉट से देयर इज नो पाप एट ऑल, वी हैव टू से पाप विच इज गोइंग टू बी बाधक फॉर ज्ञान, दैट काइंड ऑफ पाप इज नॉट देयर एट ऑल. सो ज्ञान श्रवण विल फ्रक्टिफाई इन टू ज्ञानोत्पत्ति विच इटसेल्फ इज मोक्ष, देयर बाय यू कैन नॉट से संस्कार रूप फल इज ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. तस्मात् पाप रूप मलस्य निवृत्ति रूप संस्कारोपि मोक्षो कर्मणो न फलम्. सो दैट इज नॉट अ फल इन अंतकरण ऑल्सो, इन आत्मा एनीवे देयर इज नो पाप, बट इवन इन अंतकरण there is no papa for a mumukshu which will block the jnanotpatti. Ajnanasya malatvepi tasya atmanivrutti, ajnanasya malatvepi. So atma has ajnana, if you consider ajnana itself as mala, then ajnanasya malatvepi tasya atmavruttitvepi tasya nivruttihi karmana na sambhavati. Although Atma has Ajnana resting upon itself, Atma is the Adhishthana for Ajnana, still the Nivritti of Ajnana is not possible through Karma, we have seen earlier. It is only through Jnana that Ajnana Nivritti takes place. Yataha Ajnanasya Jnanameva Virodhina Karma Avirodhitvat Karmanaha Avirodhitvat अज्ञानस्य निवृत्ति कर्मणा न संभवति. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट. सॉरी. यतः अज्ञानस्य ज्ञानम् एव विरोधी न कर्म. अज्ञान विरोधी इज ओनली ज्ञान, बिकॉज दैट नंज इन अज्ञान इज विरोधार्थे नंज. तस्मात् मुमुक्षो हो कर्मणः मल निवृत्ति रूप संस्कारो न फलम्. सो संस्कार इज आल्सो नॉट अ फल फॉर अ मुमुक्षु. यथा कौसुम्भजले मज्जन रूप कर्मण वस्त्रे रक्तवर्ण रूप गुणोत्पत्ति रूप संस्कार फलम् भवति, तथा मुमुक्षो कर्मण गुणोत्पत्ति रूप संस्कारोपि न सिद्ध्यति. सो हियर इन दिस टॉपिक ऑफ samskara itself, there are various types of samskaras possible. One is washing the cloth, that kind of samskara. Another is removing the papa. Now samskara is also adding something, you know, adding something, some guna. So example given is in something if you want to put in the red tint. So raktavarna rupa gunotpatti rupa samskara phalam bhavati. You add the red color unto sampadartha. Tatha mumuksho karmana gunotpatti rupa samskaropi na siddhyati. Similarly, you cannot add this moksha as a guna unto the mumuksho, unto the atma really of the mumuksho. Mumuksho cannot add it to himself with karma. He is himself, meaning the real self. Anyatra gunotpatte he varnayitum uk अयुक्तत्वात् आत्मन्येव गुणोत्पत्तिर वर्णनीय. नाउ वेयर इज दिस गुणोत्पत्ति गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस? यू हैव टू से इट हैज टू टेक प्लेस इन द आत्मा. निर्गुणे च तस्मिन् गुणोत्पत्तिर न घटते. आत्मा इज स्वरूपतः निर्गुण, देयर कैन नॉट बी गुणोत्पत्ति इन आत्मा, निर्गुण आत्मा. तस्मात् मुमुक्षोर गुणोत्पत्ति रूप संस्कारोपि कर्मण फलम् न संभवति. सो दिस प्यूरिफिकेशन संस्कार बाय गुणोत्पत्ति इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल. इत्थं पंचविधं एव कर्मण फलं न अन्यत्. दीज आर दी ओनली फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ रिजल्ट्स दैट वन कैन अटेन विथ कर्म, वेदर इट इज कायिक और मानसिक. मानसिक कर्म वुड बी उपासना, देयरफॉर उपासना ऑल्सो इज नॉट गोइंग टू लीड टू मोक्ष. तत् पंचविधम अपि कर्म फलं फलं मुमुक्ष विषये न घटते. सो इन द केस ऑफ मुमुक्षु हु डिजायर्स none of these, because he is not looking to deal with any padartha. No karma is, the object is being worked upon by mumukshu. he is searching his real self, which is his real nature, and jnana alone can lead to that. Leading to that is figurative because it is praptasya. Praptis asman mukshu karma parityajya jnana sadhana shravanam eva shravane eva pravartate. So having given up karma, what does mumukshu do? He does follow only shravana ityadi. So jnana sadhana shravana, shravana which is jnana sadhana, he follows only that. So jnana sadhana shravane eva mukshu parityaj, karma parityaja pravartate. Gives up karma and follows that. You cannot have karma and jnana samuchaya also. So shravana and karma samuchaya is also not going to lead to moksha. Upasana api manasam karma eva. Upasana, although it is not kayika karma, it is manasa karma. Therefore, that is also not sadhana for moksha. Tasmat tannirakarane prathag yuktihi na ukta. There is no other logical debate needed. There is no other logical refutation needed because everything that has been explained for karma will apply to manasika karma also, upasana also. Evancha kevalam karma va upasanam va na moksha karanam kintu jnanam eva moksha karanam. So karma by itself cannot lead to moksha, upasana by itself cannot lead to moksha, jnana alone can lead to moksha. Now samuchyavada has not been discussed yet. Karma upasana jnanasya mokshasya cha sadhane iti vadinam apeksha akshepaha. So akshepa, there is an opponent purvapakshi who says karma and upasana both put together can lead to moksha. So karma upasana jnanasya mokshasya cha, karma and upasana lead to jnana which lead to moksha. So karma is the direct means to jnana. If this is the objection raised, then what is your answer? Karma upasana sahitam eva jnanam moksha sadhanam iti kechit. So jnana, some say that karma and upasana together along with jnana will lead to moksha. Kechana karma upasana abhyam sahitam eva jnanam moksha sadhanam iti varnayanti tatra yuktim drishtantam api ahuhu. They give examples also to justify this viewpoint. Kechana, who are these? So prachina vrittikaraha bhartirprapancha. So vrittikara, bhartirprapancha, also called as ekadeshi at times. Brahma sutranam tika karta. He is an old tika karta, bhartirprapancha. He is a samuchyavadi. Vedanti, but a samuchyavadi. He says jnanena moksha, but not kevala jnanena moksha. It is along with karma and upasana. Tadanusarinam ayam pakshaha. Those who follow that paksha, their viewpoint is explained here. Drishtanta, what is the example they give? Yatha akashe pakshi ekena pakshina nagantum shaknoti kintu dvabhyam eva pakshabhyam gamanam bhavati tatha. So just like a bird cannot fly with a single wing, jnana is one wing, karma upasana is the other wing. How can the bird fly with one wing? How can you attain moksha with jnana alone? You will need the other wing also. Thereby, karma and upasana along with jnana will make moksha possible. Tatha jnana rupine ekena pakshina moksha lokon na gantum shakyaha. This moksha comparable as a to loka to be reached, to be attained. Kintu jnana karma bhyam eva gantum shakyaha. That loka can be reached not only by jnana but with the two wings. You need to fly with jnana karma on one side and jnana upasana on one side and karma on the karma upasana on one side and jnana on the other. I'm sorry. So jnana karma, karma includes manasa karma also. So jnana is one wing, karma or upasana or put together is the other wing. Upasana sahitam karma ekah paksha jnanam dvitiya pakshaha. So one wing is, so here when you say purva paksha, there also the wing is the option there, the other side. Here paksha means wing. So pakshi is paksham asya asti atva pakshe asya asti. Paksha is a pullinga. So pakshav asyastaha iti pakshi. One who has wings, two wings is called as a pakshi. So this bird has two wings. Similarly, the sadhaka has two wings, sadhanas. Wings are sadhanas to fly for a bird. Similarly, for a mumukshu, jnana is one wing, one sadhana, and the other sadhana is karma and upasana, the other wing, which will help the mumukshu fly to the moksha loka. Jnanam dvitiya paksha upasanasya manasa karmatvat karma upasane militva ekah paksho bhavati. So now someone may ask, you are talking about jnana, karma and upasana, there are three. How does the simile of a bird fit in? So the Purva Pakshi answers saying that jnana is one wing, karma and upasana is another wing. They can fit into a single wing because upasana is also manasa karma. Karma upasana is sakshan moksha sadhane ityapare. Now others say you don't need jnana at all. Karma and upasana themselves are moksha sadhana. Anyaha drishtanta, there they say setu darshanat. Satyasya papasya nasho bhavati setu darshanancha pratyaksha rupam jnanam. So for papa nasha, setu darshana is prescribed in the shastras. Setu is Rama Setu, built by Rama and Vanara Sena to bring back Mother Sita from Lanka. So they had built this setu on the samudra. So that setu darshana, nowadays it may be very easy. In the earlier era, where traveling was by foot or bullock carts and things like that, going to Kashi was a big deal. Going to Kashi is like attainment of the entire life. One may not come back at all because it will take several months and years to reach Kashi. Similarly, Setu Darshana, from someone from north goes to Samudra, he has not seen a Samudra at all. That's why you have examples in Bahuri like Drishta Samudra. Drishta Samudra is not a big deal today. Anybody from any corner of the world can reach any of the samudras also with not more than several hours of travel. So Drishta Samudra is not a big deal, a person who has seen samudra. But traveling by foot, taking so much trouble and reaching this corner of India where one would have Setu Darshana, that effort and looking at the Setu, because it is prescribed by the Shastra, will take away Papa. So this is an example of the Purva Pakshi. Setu Darshana Satyasya Papasya Nasho Bhavati, that Papa which is existent will go away. Setu Darshanancha Pratyaksha Rupam Jnanam. And what is Setu Darshana? Darshana is the cognition of the Setu, that Darshana is Jnana. Because Indriyajanya, that Jnana is Indriyajanya Pratyaksha. So Pratyaksha Rupa Jnana, Setu Darshana is going to lead to Pratyaksha Jnana. Tachcha Jnana Rupam Setu Darshanam Shraddha Bhakti Sahita Gamanadi Niyamam Api Apekshate. Now this Jnana, Setu Darshana Jnana, that has an expectancy of Shraddha Bhakti. Shraddha in Shastra should be there, Bhakti should be there. Then one should be devoted to Shastras or Rama. There is Bhakti expected. Then along with that, one has to not only sit at home with Shraddha and Bhakti, one has to do the Gamana Kriya also. So all these, Adipadena, everything else that is going to support reaching there, all that is expected. Shraddhadi Rahita Purushasya Na. So Na I have added, it should be there. Shraddhadi Rahita Purushasya Na Setu Darshanat Phala Siddhir Iti Shastra Siddhantat. So Setu Darshanat Phala Asiddhi. So Na is not needed here because there is a Setu Darshanat Phala Asiddhir Shraddhadi Rahita Purushasya. I was just reading this, I missed this A here. So, A is this negation. In the Samasa itself, this A is added there. Shraddhadi Rahita Purushasya. One who is bereft of Shraddha Bhakti. Shraddhadi. So, Bhakti isn't there. None of these add-ons are there. Just Setu Darshana is not going to lead to Papa Nasha. There are many who may go to have a look at this bridge. Is it really there? Somebody says, oh, NASA has picturized it. Oh, let me have a look. It is not going to bring in papanasha. Shraddha is needed in shastras. It is a shastra, shastra ukta vidhi. So shastra ukta vidhi, that alone will work as taking away papa, work as resulting in taking away papa. So shraddhadi rahita purushasya setu darshanat phalasya asiddhi iti shastra siddhantat. Shastra says that only for one who has shraddha and follows accordingly, follows the scriptures accordingly, for him there will be punya and papa, papa nasha here. Yatha setu darshan rupam pratyaksha jnanam swaphala papa nashotpatto shraddha niyamadikam apekshate tatha brahma jnanavi moksha rupa phalotpatto karmopasanadi kam apekshate. So karma and upasanas are also subsidiaries to jnana. Just like this pratyaksha jnana, although it takes place, it does not give you phala. What is a phala? The pratyaksha rupa jnana is indriya janya phala. Chakshur indriya and setu as a karma to the chakshur indriya. The kriya takes place. Vritti rupa jnana takes place and that jnana is a result of indriya and setu sanyoga. Chakshur indriya, setu sanyoga will give you jnana, all right, but that jnana will not result in papanasha. Papanasha is the phala expected, and that phala has dependency not only on chakshur indriya and the setu sanyoga janya pratyaksha jnanam, but also shraddhadi. Similarly here, your jnana that you talk about, moksha, for moksha you are talking about jnana, the siddhanti. Advaitin is talking about this jnana, which will be aparoksha jnana, that aparoksha jnana pratyakshavat, it is jnana. That has a dependency on karma and upasana to result in moksha. So that moksha rupa phala is not going to be possible if you have kevala jnana, just like setu darshana. Kevala setu darshana is not going to bring in papanasha. So this example the samuchyavadi uses. Yatha setu darshana rupam pratyaksha jnanam swaphala papanashotpattau shraddha niyamadikam apekshate tatha brahma jnanam. This brahma jnana may take place but it will not lead to moksha. Why? Moksha rupa phalotpattau karma upasana adikam apekshate. Expects karma and upasana also. There is a dependency. Kevala jnanena moksha siddhyati ityangi kurvana api karma upasane jnanasya sadhane iti manyate. Now he says moksha is a resultant of only jnana. But is that jnana going to take place without karma upasana? Karma upasana is jnana sadhana. For jnana to take place also karma is needed, upasana is also needed. Tatha hi shuddhe nischale cha antakkarane jnanam udeti. Why? Because jnana will take place in shuddha antakkarana. Tachcha antakkaranam shubhakarmana shuddhyati. Upasanena nischali bhavati. Karma makes this antakkarana shuddha. Upasana makes it sthira. Then only this jnanotpatti can take place. Ittham antakkaranasya shuddhi naischalya sampadana dvara karmopasana jnana sadhane iti angikrutam. Thereby, what is accepted is that karma and upasana are going to lead to chitta shuddhi, and through that there is sadhanatvam accepted for karma and upasana as sadhana to jnana. And jnana leads to moksha as per those who say that kevala jnana is moksha sadhana. In the tippana, there was an elaboration here. Atra idam niyam. Samasamuchya. So, this has to be known. When you talk about samuchya, samuchyas are of two types. Samasamuchya and kramasamuchya. Samasamuchya means doing them together. Jnana karma should go together as moksha sadhana. Kramasamuchya is that karma precedes jnana. They don't go together, they are both needed, but kramena. Karma will lead to chitta shuddhi, chitta shuddhi will lead to jnanotpatti. When shravana is taking place, shravana is sadhana, but chitta shuddhi is necessary for shravana to fructify into aparoksha jnana. Thereby krama samuchya is accepted. Siddhanti accepts krama samuchya, not sama samuchya. When Bhagavan Bhashyakara refutes the samuchya, he is refuting the sama samuchya. Together, karma or upasana along with jnana leading to moksha is negated, but karma and upasana needed for chitta shuddhi, whereby shravana can lead to jnana. As jnana sadhana, karma and upasana are accepted. So sama samuchya, karma samuchya, krama samuchya iti samuchya dvividha. There are two types of samuchya, sama samuchya together and krama samuchya sequentially. Agnihotradi karmanam shravanadischa yugapaddeva anushtanam sama samuchya antakkarana shuddhyartam vividisha siddhi paryantam nitya karma anushteyam siddhayam tu vividishayam karma sanyasya shravanadina jnanam sampadaniyam iti krama samuchya. So in the earlier case of sama samuchya, agnihotra, karma ityadi and shravana are together the sadhanas, taken as sadhanas. Practice of agnihotradi should continue, performance along with shravana. That is sama samuchya. Whereas in krama samuchya, till antakkarana shuddhi is at a good level, till then antakarana shuddhyartham, for the purpose of purification of the antakarana, karma and upasanas as prescribed in the shastra, nitya naimittika karma, should be done. What will it lead to? Vividisha siddhi. So vividisha siddhi paryantam. Vividisha is veditum iccha. One will become a jijnyasu. And once one becomes a jijnyasu, one has to drop the karma. Then siddhayam tu vividishayam karma sanyasya. One should take sannyasa and then do shravana after sannyasa. This is the orthodox paksha really, and krama samuchya is accepted. Tatra sama samuchyaha tyajyaha. Sama samuchya should be dropped, whereas krama samuchya grahya iti sarva veda tatparyam. Krama samuchya is acceptable as per every advaitin. Tatra tatra khandanam api sama samuchyasya eva na krama samuchyasya. Whenever there is khandana of samuchya, it is not that nobody should do karma, everyone should do karma, but not for moksha, for jnanotpatti, for chitta shuddhi. After chitta shuddhi, karma has to be dropped, the ashrama has to be dropped for shravana mana nididhyasana. Even if shravana is being done, it will not result in moksha till nishtha is there, and nishtha is possible. It is accepted that nishtha is possible when commitment is not divided. Commitment has to be singular. That only makes or breaks a mumukshu. Karmopasane paramparaya mokshasya api sadhane iti anye. Others say karma and upasana are not sadhana for chitta shuddhi alone, but they lead to moksha. Kramena, but they will lead to moksha. Yatha karmopasane jnana sadhanatvena angikrite. Just like you accept that karma upasana are not moksha sadhana, but they are jnana sadhana. Tatha jnana phala moksha sadhane iti api angikartum uchitam. So tatha jnana phala moksha sadhane. Similarly, you have to accept it as sadhana for moksha also, which is jnana phala. You say it as jnana phala, moksha is jnana phala, but in that jnana phala, which is moksha, moksha se sadhane api karmopasane angi kartum uchitam. You have to accept them as sadhana for moksha also. There is a drishtanta for that. Drishtanta yatha jalasya sechanam vrukshasya utpattim prati vruksha phalasya utpattim prati cha sadhanam. तथा कर्मोपासने ज्ञानोत्पत्तिं प्रति ज्ञान फल मोक्षस्य उत्पत्तिं प्रति च साधने भवतः. एग्जाम्पल इज ऑफ अ वृक्ष. सो यू वाटर अ प्लांट, वाटर अ ट्री, यथा जलस्य सेचनम्. दिस वाटरिंग द प्लांट इज अ साधना. फॉर व्हाट? फॉर द बेसिकली वाटर अ सीड फर्स्ट, देन अंकुर, इट ग्रोज अप टू बिकम अ वृक्ष. सो वृक्षस्य उत्पत्तिं, फॉर दिस सीड टू स्प्राउट, ग्रो, बिकम एन अंकुरा एंड देन अ प्लांट एंड देन अ ट्री. व्हाट इज ए साधना? वॉटरिंग इज ए साधना. सो जलसेचना इज साधना फॉर वृक्षोत्पत्ति. देन वृक्षफलस्य, आफ्टर द वृक्ष कम्स इन, यू नो वृक्ष इज फुल्ली ग्रोन, यू स्टिल हैव टू वॉटर. लाइक कोकोनट ट्रीज, you have to water it, otherwise coconut tree will not give you phala. Mango trees will give you phala, the rain water is sufficient, you are not watering, but rains are still needed. So vruksha needs jala sechana to grow up as well as fructify. So now this fructification need not be separated. If you separate it, still you will have to accept as there are two results. One is vrukshotpatti, another is vrukshaphala utpatti, let's say. For both, jalasechana is karana. Similarly here, tatha karmopasane jnanotpattim prati jnana phala mokshasya utpattim prati cha sadhane bhavataha. So you need not say that karma upasana is sadhana for jnana alone, but not for jnana phala, which is moksha, but you have to accept that karma and upasana are sadhanas for jnanotpatti as well as jnana phalotpatti, mokshotpatti. Nacha vane sthitasya vrikshasya phalam jalasechanam vina api utpadyate iti vachyam. You cannot say that the forest trees have fruits as well, they bear fruits without any watering. Tatra api vrikshasya mule bhumistha jalena sambandho asti. The roots go deep, you don't see the roots, but the roots go deep in the ground, bhumi, searching for water. And jalastha, there is lot of jalastha jala, bhumistha jala. So there is bhumistha jala. You dig borewells to find water, you dig wells and borewells, you go deep in the bhumi to search for water. Similarly the vruksha also does it. So you may not see jalasechana being done, but the vruksha is searching through its roots, it's searching water, so water is there. Tatrapi vrukshasya mule bhumistha jalena sambandho asti tena jalena vrukshasya phalam utpadyate. So it is not without any karana, the karana is there, jalasechana is karana even for the forest trees to fructify. Jala sambandha bhave vruksha sushyet, the jalasechana abhava, jala sambandha abhava, if there is no contact with water, the tree dries away. And this is dealt with in a different manner, jalasechana, but the life of a tree is discussed in Chandogya Upanishad also in the 6th chapter. Phalam apina utpadyeta, there won't be phala also because a dry tree is struggling to survive, there are no leaves also. Where will the fruit come from? It is not going to flower and bear fruits. Tasmat karmopasane jnanasya jnanam phala mokshasya cha sadhane. And with this example, it is established that just like water, watering a plant is sadhana for the plant to become a tree as well as the tree to fructify. Similarly, karma and upasana are both sadhana for both ज्ञानोत्पत्ति एज वेल एज ज्ञान फल मोक्ष उत्पत्ति एवं च कर्म उपासनम ज्ञानम च इति त्रीण्यपि मोक्षस्य साधनानि. ऑल थ्री आर मोक्ष साधनास, उपासना, कर्म एंड ज्ञान. तस्मात् ज्ञान्यपि कर्माणि अनुतिष्ठेदेव. देयरफॉर इवन अ ज्ञानी शुड होल्ड ऑन टू दिस मोक्ष बाय डूइंग कर्म एंड उपासना. समुत्पन्न ज्ञान संरक्षणार्थम अपि कर्मोपासने अपेक्षिते. दिस इज अनदर पक्ष. नाउ दिस कैन बी सीन इन मोर डिटेल इन जीवन मुक्ति विवेक आल्सो. सो समुत्पन्न ज्ञान संरक्षणार्थम, ज्ञान संरक्षण इज डिस्कस्ड इन जीवन मुक्ति विवेक. भगवान विद्यारण्याचार्य सेज दिस, ज्ञान रक्षण हैज टू बी डन. दिस ज्ञान लाइक एन अंकुर विच इज जस्ट स्प्राउटिंग, इट्स अ प्लांट. इवन अ स्मॉल, यू नो, नॉट अ स्टॉर्मी बट अ स्मॉल विंड can destroy the plant. Similarly, this jnana which is there has to be protected till it becomes so strong that nothing can move the jnani. Just like the plant has to be fenced till it becomes a tree, then that tree can support even an elephant. You can tie, so if it's a huge tree, an elephant can be tied to the tree, whereas as this when this same tree was a small plant, even a goat would destroy it, even a cat or a goat would destroy it, it can now hold an elephant. This is the status of jnana also. Jnana rakshana has to be done till it becomes strong, and therefore all what has to be done is discussed there in Except for nishtha, what has to be done. So yogic practices are suggested. One cannot give up the sadhana chatushte sampatti. Shamadhi sadhana sampatti should never be given up. That is the idea there. It is not said that karma and upasana should be practiced, because karma and upasana are prescribed by shastras for a karmi, for a karta. Jnani is no longer a karta. If jnani is not a karta, he has no vidhi to follow. He has no adhikara in any vidhi to follow, because he is not a karta. He has no adhikara at all. So jnana saurakshana, how will he do? Karma upasana are not going to help him, because they are not going to support the jnana at all. They are jnana virodhi, because they are ajnana karya. So their yoga prakriya is prescribed. So samadhi is suggested, prescribed inside, is suggested for jnana rakshana ityadi. So punah punah shravanam kuryat. Shravana manana nididhyasana should be continuous. Nididhyasana is dhyana rupa. It is differentiated from the upasana, as we saw earlier, because upasana is shastra vihita, whereas nididhyasana is not shastra vihita in that sense. No karta is expected there. गीताचार्य ऑल्सो सेज दिस, सो ज्ञानारूढस्य तस्यैव शम कारणम उच्यते. सो शम कैन नॉट बी ड्रॉप, शमदमादि शम इज संन्यास देयर रियली. सो कर्म कैन नॉट बी एडेड बैक, इट हैज टू बी गिवन अप अर्लियर. इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन अप, देन इट हैज टू गिवन अप देन फॉर निष्ठा, फॉर इफ नॉट फॉर विविदिशा देन फॉर विद्वत बाय विद्वान. सो विविदिशा sannyasa and vidvat sannyasa are two types of sannyasas discussed. Yajnavalkya sannyasa in Brihadaranyaka was vidvat sannyasa. He wouldn't have taken that sannyasa if karma and upasana were expected. He has no adhikara in karma upasana after he drops off the ashrama, grastha ashrama. Athva karma upasane samutpannam jnanam samrakshitum hetu bhavataha. So this jnana rakshana was not expected earlier, because there was no jnana earlier. So karma upasane samutpannam jnanam samrakshitum, whatever is the cause for jnana, to hold on to that jnana, karma and upasanas are hetu now. They were not a hetu earlier, now they are hetu. So chi pratyanta hetu bhavataha, these become a hetu now. Or hetu bhavata can be taken as a separate words also, need not be chi pratyanta, so to say. So now when karma upasanas are hetus for jnana rakshana, this is one paksha. There jnani karma upasane tyajati chet, if one gives up those karma and upasana which are expected to protect the jnana which is there, which makes jnani a jnani, jnanam asti asti iti jnani, Matup arthe ini has been added to give the word jnani. This person is called as a jnani because he has jnana. This jnana, if it is not protected, then how will he remain a jnani? Then what will happen? Tada yatha jala sambandha bhave prarudho pi vriksha sushyati. Even a grown-up tree, fully grown-up tree will dry away and wither away. Tatha jnanina utpanna pi jnanam vinashyet. This jnana, which made this jnani a jnani, will go away. Tata hi shuddhi antakarne jnanam utpadyate. Shubha karmanam akarne jnanina papam bhavet. This shuddha antakarna is papa nashanantaram. So it is possible only when punya is resulting due to nitya naimittika karma. So nitya naimittika karma has given you punya, and this karma not being kamya karma, it is going to result in chitta shuddhi. So that punya is being utilized for chitta shuddhi, that punya is being earned by nitya naimittika karma, upasana ityadi. That shuddha antakarna will become this, the basis in which they be the sadhana, be the karana in which jnana can take place, or adhikarana in which, shuddha adhikarana in which jnanotpatti can take place. Through the buddhi, in the buddhi, this jnana will take place. That buddhi is shuddha due to karma and upasana. So tatahi shuddhi antakarane jnanam utpadyate shubha karmanam akarane. If one does not do this karma which leads to punya, shubha karma, then akarane jnaninaha papam bhave, then there won't be punya, which is a kavacha, there will be papa. Pratyavaya dosha also will accrue. Upasana karane jnanina chittam punarapi chanchalyam bhajet. Then this karma which had made the antakarana shuddha, upasana which had made it very composed, both will go away if both are dropped. So result of karma which was punya, which was chitta shuddhi, leading to chitta shuddhi, that kind of karma has been stopped by the jnani. So there won't be any shuddhi now, there will be papa in fact, because there is no punya, there will be papa also. Instead of shuddhi, there will be ashuddhi. Then upasana had brought in sthiri bhava of the chitta. That sthiri bhava will go away and buddhi will become asthira or chanchala. So upasana karane jnanina chittam punarapi chanchalyam bhajeta. So jnanina papam bhavet. Why? Karmana makarane. When karma is not done. And punarapi jnaninaha chittam chanchalyam bhajeta. There will be chanchala, mana will become chanchala. Arjuna had objected to this. Now this jnani is mana, if it is chanchala, then what has jnani attained? There is no nishtha. So it will be jnani matra, and that jnana will also go away. This is the objection there. Tasmin ashuddhe chanchale cha antakkarane shushkabhumau utpanna vrikshavat jnanam navastitam bhavet. If you do not water the plant, and watering the plant is watering its roots. You don't water its leaves and fruits. You water the ground on which it stands. If the ground dries up, then there is no water possible for the vriksha, and then it dries up. So it should be on wet ground. Similarly, this jnana should be on that kind of a wet ground of antakarana, which makes it possible for this jnana vriksha to stand. Jnana should not dry up. It should be fed by karma and upasana, so that it keeps on flowering and fructifying. That kind of jnana won't be there, because this dried vrikshavat, like the shushka vrikshavat or shushka bhuma utpanna vrikshavat, that vriksha which is there on dry ground, even if it has come up somehow, there was water earlier, now it has taken away, the earth has dried, And it is like becoming a desert now. In the deserted land, there won't be a vruksha, it will die away. Similarly, on this, in this antakarana where karma and upasana have deserted, what will happen? This jnana vruksha will fall. So, shushka bhuma utpanna vrukshavat jnanam na avasthitam bhavet. It will be asthira jnana. That jnana is useless. This is the objection there. Aparaha drishtanta. Another example is given. Yatha parimarjana prokshanadi samskarehi shuddhim apadite sthane vedadhyana shali brahmachari nivasati. Where does the brahmachari reside? In a shuddha place. Surrounding should be shuddha. Let's say he has a place to do his sandhya ityadi. There he'll do prokshana. He'll sprinkle water, etc. And make the surrounding shuddha before he does his sandhyadi karma. So, yatha parimarjana prokshanadi samskari. This samskara will purify the surroundings. Thereby, sthana shuddhi is necessary. Shuddhim apadite sthane. Only in that kind of sthana where water has been sprinkled and it's kept pure, then alone he will continue with his karma. Nitya naimitya. Vedadhyana shali brahmachari nivasati. So, this brahmachari will stay only in such a place. Yena kena api karana tasmin sthane ashuddhim apadite. Sa tatra na tishtati. That brahmachari will leave that place when the surroundings get ashuddha. Kintu tatsthanam parityajati. He gives up that place. He will not stay there anymore because it is not conducive for his karma ityadi. Tatha karmopasanadi tyagena ashuddhim chanchalyam cha prapte antakkarane jnanam na tishtate. Similarly, this brahmachari vat jnanam will give away that place which is chanchala, that buddhi which is chanchala, which is ashuddha. Why? Chanchala because upasana is not being done, and ashuddha because karma is not being done. From that kind of buddhi, the brahmachari vat jnana will go away. Jnana is like that brahmachari, it will not stay anymore. Tasmat karma upasane jnana samrakshane hetu bhavatah. Thereby, karma and upasana are needed even after jnana utpatti to protect this jnana. Tathacha karma, upasanam, jnanam chaiti, trini, moksha karanani, iti angikare, karma upasane, jnana samrakshana hetu bhute, kevalam jnanam mokshasya hetu, iti angikare cha, jnanina karma upasane anushteye eva. Whether you say they are means to jnana and moksha, or you say that they are means to jnana alone, not moksha, still for jnana samrakshana, this karma and upasana will be needed. Ayam samuchyavada iti uchyate. This is what is called as samuchyavada. And by samuchyavada, we mean sama samuchyavada, not krama samuchyavada. Karma upasana yor jnanena sa virodha iti purvokta akshepanam samadhanam. So the refutation of all these pakshas is what? Karma and upasana have virodha with jnana. Together you cannot do that. Because in every aspect there is virodha between karma upasana on one side and jnana on the other. All karaka mardana is done. All karakas are churani krita in jnana. Whereas karma and upasana need the kartru karaka, karma karaka, adhikarana karaka, karana karaka. All these are needed. In karma and upasana, divisions are entertained, are supposed to be entertained, accumulated, more the merrier, and then you indulge in bringing out a desired result. Whereas jnana is going to destroy all these karakas. All the bhedas are going to be destroyed. The karta himself will vanish from being a karta. Where is the question of they supporting? Where is the question of them supporting your pursuit? Karma jnanasya virodhi. Soyam samuchyavadaha na samichina. This samuchyavada is not acceptable. It is not appropriate. Yesham देहातिरिक्त आत्मज्ञान नास्ति तेषां कर्म न संभवति. दोज हु डू नॉट हैव ज्ञान ऑफ व्हाट देहातिरिक्त आत्मज्ञान येषां नास्ति. जन्मांतरे भोगाय ही कर्म अनुष्ठीयते. दोज हु से दैट आई एम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द शरीर एंड ऑल द शरीरस ऑफ कोर्स दैट That kind of I will survive to go to another loka. Those who do not think that there is anything else other than me, they can't have karma ityadi. Janmantare bhoga hi karma anushtiyate. I'll have another janma and then I'll have different kind of bhoga in different loka or the same loka in a different sharira. This is the thinking of a karmi. Dehastu agnina dayyate. This deha is burnt by agni. तस्मात् देहेन जन्मांतर भोगो न सिद्ध्यति. द सेम देह इज नॉट गोइंग टू गेट अनदर लोका एंड भोगा इन अनदर शरीर अनदर लोका. द देह इज गोइंग टू बी बर्न. तस्मात् देहातिरिक्त आत्मज्ञानम कर्मणः हेतु. वन हैज टू सो दिस इज मूविंग फ्रॉम अ चार्वाका टू अ कर्मी ऑल्सो द सेम लॉजिक इज यूज्ड हियर. दिस लॉजिक इज शोन इवन अ कर्मी. Why is he doing karma? He is doing karma. Which karma? Karma in the case of Shastra is dharma. So it's a Vaidika karma. There is no other karma. Karma means Vaidika karma. If there is a specific other karma, the Laukika karmas are described. But karma without a qualification in Shastras is just Shastriya karma. Not any karma. So here it is Shastra Vidhi, that karma is due to Shastra Vidhi. Dehastu agnina dayyate tasmat dehena janmantara bhogo na siddhyati. So whoever is doing karma is doing Shastriya karma. That Shastriya karma is not doing for phala here and now. It may be, but there are very rare phalas here and now. Most of the karmas have adrushta phala, which will be in another loka or in another janma. We don't know whether they are going to fructify even the even some of the karmas which may have immediate results. We don't know that they have given immediate results. We may not know rather. There are other dependencies, but most of the karmas are for adrushta phala. Most of the karmas are leading to swarga phala or another loka phala which cannot be in this janma. So I have to survive this deha. This jnana should be there. So atma is different from sharira. Tasmat dehatirikta atmajnanam karmanah hetuhu. What is the cause for reason for karma, for anyone doing karma? This jnana has to be there preceding the karma that I am different from the body. Because the body won't travel, it won't survive, it will be burnt. I will travel after this body is burnt to another loka to get the result of all the karmas that I am earning using this body. Tasya deha bhinnasya atmana kartrutva bhoktrutva jnanam api karmana hetuhu. This deha bhinna atma is karta, bhokta. That kind of understanding should be there. If the jnani, who is not a karmi, who has this deha bhinna atma jnana, because jnani also has deha bhinna atma jnana. Initially he says deha bhinna atma, aham asmi. So the deha is going to die, I am not going to die. So amrutattvam is desirable in both cases. Karmi and jnani's case, both need amrutattvam. Both want, desire amrutattvam. Earlier one wants it through karma, the latter knows that it cannot be through karma. Kritena karmana akkritaha moksha nasti. Therefore, he becomes a vairagi. Now, the Shuddha Laukika, Charvaka, has no Deha Bhinna Atma Jnana. So, Deha Bhinna Atma Jnana is needed for a Karmi or as well as a Jnani, initially. Then the Atma Jnani says that there is nothing other than Atma. So, Atma Bhinna Deha Eva Nasti, Shariram Eva Nasti. That is the understanding of the Jnani. Anyway, that's an aside. So deha bhinna se atmana. Now this deha bhinna atma in the case of karmi and a jnani, what is the difference? Both have deha bhinna atma jnana. The karmi, however, has a deha bhinna atma jnana, with the jnana of that atma being karta bhokta, whereas jnani knows that atma, I am not karta bhokta. So tasya deha bhinnasya atmana kartrutva bhoktrutva jnanam api karmanah hetu farakarmi aham punya papayo karta tayo karmanah tayo karmano phalam mama bhavishyati iti jnanam yasya asti sa eva karma karoti. Who does karma? One who knows that I am different from the body mind sense complex, but I am a karta bhokta, I will be a ganta, I will travel to another loka and get the punya or papa phala. Jnani tu atmanam evam na janati. Jnani knows the atma, but not in this manner as the karmi does. Kintu punya papa sukadukhadi rahita asanga brahmarupa eva atma asti saha aham. I am that atma which is free from punya and papa, kartrutva bhoktrutva, sukadukhadi, because I am asanga brahma. Iti vedanta janyam jnana jnaninah asti. This jnana is there for a jnani. Idam cha jnanam karmanah na hetuhu pratyuta karmano virodhi. So virodhi, this jnana is virodhi of karma. How will he do karma? Adhikara itself is not there. He is not a karta at all. He is asanga atma. With that asanga atma jnana, he cannot go and end up doing karma. There is no hetu. There is no reason at all. There is no basis for him to act. Tasmat jnana jnanini karma na sambhavati. In this jnani, karma is not possible. Kincha kartuhu karma phalasya cha bheda jnanam karmano hetuhu. There is also a difference. Karma phalasya, kartuhu and karma phala. I am the karta, karma phala is to be attained. So that karma phala, which we have seen in the earlier five types of phalas possible by karma. This is expected in the case of a karmi. Sakarta karma phalancha jnaninah svatmanah bhinnataya na pratiyete. That karta as well as karma is not seen by the jnani as well as the karma phala. No karakas are seen. So karma is not there. Karma phala is also not there. Here we are looking at karta and karma phala. Karta has to attain karma phala. But in the case of jnani, karta and karma phala are not separate at all. There is no separate existence for a karta. There is no separate existence of karma phala also. So this sanyoga is not possible. There is no bhinnatvam at all. There is nothing other than atma brahma. Jnaninah sarvam atma swarupena eva pratiyate. Everything is atma. So what will he have karakas as to do this karma and attain the karma phala? Tasmadapi jnanina karma na sambhavati. There is no possibility of karma for jnani for this reason also. Bhashyakarair jnaninah karma bhavo nana prakarahi pradipaditah. So there is pratipadanam of, there is elaborate discussion by Bhagavan Bhashyakara under each and every Upanishad, under each and every Gita chapter also even, where he discusses this karma abhava for jnani. Karmano jnanasya cha phalatah api virodhasti. There is virodha in phala also. Karmanah jnanasya cha. Between jnana and karma, phala rupa virodha is also there. Tasmad api jnana karmano samuchya na yujyate. This is also the reason why there is no samuchya possible between jnana and karma. Karmanah phala manitya samsara. Wow, what is the virodha there? Samsara is the phala of karma. Karma will keep a person in samsara. He will keep on transmigrating. Whereas, jnanasya phalam nitya moksha. Anitya samsara versus nitya moksha are completely opposite to each other, contradictory to each other. One is the karma phala, other is jnana phala. And it is not really phala. Jnanasya phalam nitya moksha, but phala literally has been denied. This is figurative. Nitya, nitya can be no phala. Nitya and phala itself is contradictory, because nitya means it is not going to have laya. It will not phalgutaya na liyate. So it cannot be phalam. That is nitya. So anyway, we'll look at more in the next part. We'll try to start on time. सुख नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धेर् दृक्यत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परमा तदेवान्नमत्वं नेतुं निश्चितामतिः तत्सत्। एनी क्वेश्चंस? नमस्ते।